The next couple of years marked a change of direction for Jane and her family.
We're raising funds for the community of Leeds, and it was nice to have that recognition.
Oh no,
I didn't think there were going to be that many people, but it turned out there were loads. I see her as just my mum, but other people see her as a person who's done such a lot to raise money for charities. So.
While Jane initially continued to do her personal challenges, the family was clearing its ambitions to create a lasting legacy, which would come to fruition in the series of events in Jane's name. But first, the funds had to be raised to set these plans in motion. Jane's next big effort took months to plan, but was to be her biggest and ultimately final epic endeavour. In June, Jane began her ride across America, a 4,200-mile journey across the USA from San Francisco to New York. Fighting deteriorating health and often agonizing pain, Jane also had Mother Nature to brave.
We just want to make sure we're not going to get struck by lightning.
I think we should go now.
Yeah, I think we should go now.
Oh, it's a very strange day.
We've cycled over 83 miles today, which is the longest distance so far on this tour. We've spent that night at Milford. It's not very glamorous where we park the RVs for the night, and we're heading for Cedar City. Wind makes it like somebody's pushing against you all the time.
Jane's fought her way over the mountain range behind us, and when she was hoping for a rest, she's now having to pedal downhill against this wind.
I hope everyone realizes what she's actually doing here and pitches in and shows her support.
With just 10 rest days on the 10-week journey, she battled climbs of up to 13,000 feet, sweltering desert temperatures of up to 110 degrees Fahrenheit, gale force winds, and even swarms of migrating insects. It's hard to understand just from where Jane found the mental and physical strength to finish this Herculean ride, but she confounded almost everyone by doing just that. In January, Jane and her family announced plans for a new mass participation sporting event for Leeds, one that would hopefully carry on Jane's good works for years to come. The Leeds 10K, it was hoped, would encourage thousands to achieve a personal goal while raising funds for local causes. Named Run for All, the event's organisation's ethos was clear from the beginning.
The title Run for All is to try and encompass all charities, all abilities, and just about everybody in the community to be able to take part in an athletic event.
Jane's remarkable achievements were recognised once more in June, when it was revealed she'd been honoured with a CBE in the Queen's Birthday Honours.
I was awarded an MBE in the Queen's Birthday Honours list. I was very surprised, and it was a big honour.
Jane, Mrs. Tomlinson, for services to charity in West Yorkshire.
It was a wonderful day, and the family was there. And it's just one of those days. How can you describe? You're sitting in the palace. You're sitting in the palace, and you go and collect an award from the Queen with your family looking on. You can't get any better than that.
She just asked me about my running and just said to keep on running, and that was about it. It's very, very brief. It's over very quickly, and it's intensely nerve-wracking.
And what about meeting Sting?
I think he received the OBE on that day, and I just got the opportunity to say hello to him. And it's quite strange going to places and meeting people that you've maybe just seen from afar, listen to the music and seen them on the telly, to actually meet them face to face. It's very, very strange.
I'll be on telly with that.
Later that month came the moment that had been years in the making, the running of the first Leeds 10K. Jane's pride was clear for all to see when she set off more than 8,000 runners and turned the city into a sea of colour. Tears flowed as Jane also welcomed the runners home.
I'm really, really pleased. It's been, the atmosphere has been absolutely tremendous all day. All the people who've come out to support, I can't believe how many people have come out to support the event.
It was to become a bittersweet moment in the event's history. While Jane lived long enough to realise her long-held dream, she sadly lost her fight with cancer just 3 months later. Posthumously, Jane's achievements continued to be recognised. In November, her son Stephen, then just 10, collected her CBE from Prince Charles in a moving ceremony at Buckingham Palace. While in December, she was once more voted British Woman of the Year. In 2008, the scale of Jane's legacy became clear, as it was revealed the first ever Leeds 10K had raised an amazing £413,586 for charity. In April, following in her mother's footsteps, Jane's daughter Rebecca ran the London Marathon. In June, a record 11,000 paid tribute to Jane by taking part in the second Leeds 10K. While in July, it was Jane's husband Mike's turn to take on a challenge, with he and Rebecca hopping into the saddle to repeat Jane's 1,300-mile cycle ride from John O'Groats to Land's End.